There is an ambition in Scotland to reach towards a vision that by 2020, everyone is able to live longer, healthier lives at home or in a homely setting. We will have integrated health and social care with a focus on prevention, anticipation, and supported self-management. Whatever the setting, care will be provided to the highest standards of quality and safety, with the person at the centre of all decisions. Here in Scotland, the Person-Centred Health and Care Collaborative focuses on what can be done now to improve services, aiming to provide reliable opportunities to personalise support for every person, all of the time.
Person-centeredness for me is the essence of why we're here. It's the values that underpin the way we go about our business.
People don't live their lives in the neat compartments that we've created, for the best of reasons, for delivery purposes. So it means being ready to look at those again.
Person-centeredness is very much about finding the true essence of the individual and recognising that the individual isn't just a collection of signs and symptoms, but is a much more complete human being that we need to support and address that issue when we're caring for people.
It's about finding out really what's important to the person and tailoring our care to what's important to them.
I think today we're actually getting to the heart of what the meaning of this is, and it's really about asking but listening.
The Collaborative supports people to develop and test a range of tools and approaches designed to improve person-centred care.
The nurse said that we'd have the results for today.
I was off yesterday.
The aim is to build a community of people working and learning together in a systematic way to develop and embed person-centeredness into every aspect of health and care.
They got this chap called Göran Henriks to come from Sweden and talk to us about initiatives. But the thing that really captured my imagination were these things called learning cafes. And the whole concept that underpins them is that patients are best at teaching patients about experiences.
Right to the end of her life, my mother was able to be brought back to a sense of herself by music. So in a reckless moment, I took a very deep breath and I founded the charity Playlist for Life. Although it's still very early days, we have seen one person after another reconnected to their loved ones through sharing the music from their past on an iPod.
And because you just can't tell if somebody's understood by looking at them or indeed asking them, we actually have to check their understanding. And we can do this by a mechanism that we call TeachBack. And the idea of TeachBack is that what I do is I put the spotlight on myself. I often say, look, I'm really struggle sometimes to make myself clear. I wonder if you could just tell me what you've understood. Or I might say, you know, we've discussed a lot today, there's a lot to take in. Would you mind just telling me what you might go home and tell your partner?
On my first day back, I went into our little huddle and spoke to our doctors and said, okay, today, instead of asking what's the matter with you, ask what matters to the patient. So I used the improvement methodology to think about what I was trying to accomplish. And that was not to assume we know what matters to the children, but actually, here's a thing, just ask them and respond to what they say. So every child old enough to do so was given the opportunity to draw or write a poster that they put up on their cubicle door or on their bed about what mattered to them while they were in hospital. This is one of my favourite examples. I've got hundreds of these, but I love this one. It's a 12-year-old boy, Declan. Number one was no moaning.
The Collaborative encourages sharing of ideas and approaches between people who use services and people who provide them. Promoting the use of approaches for obtaining feedback from people who use services to drive forward improvements.
The most effective tool we patients have is to tell those stories. And why? Because those stories evoke feelings.
A lot of the systems in the NHS these days are historic and are really based around the staff and not patients. And I think a lot of being person-centred is recognising that and questioning some of those systems and trying to change it to make it more for the patient as opposed to for us.
We're often dealing with people at the most vulnerable parts in their life. Some people are literally fighting for life. Some people are trying to make sense of the changes in their life. And they just want to know that we are listening, we're taking their wishes on board, and we're helping them to understand the choices that they might make so that they can do what they want to do for the rest of their lives.